Kenyatta.
2 weeks after the Jubilee government was sworn in, its wheels are turning at a paralytic pace. With cabinet secretaries yet to be appointed and the current permanent secretaries forced to reapply for their jobs, not much seems to be happening, and it's easy to see why. PSs who are still holding brief before the transition to a new government is complete are among the 155 candidates who have been shortlisted for principal secretary positions. And with interviews pending, none is willing to sign any documents or commit to any official position until they know their fate. In the actual functioning of government, there is little cabinet secretaries actually do that PSs can't. They attend cabinet meetings, change policy, and appoint members to boards. But it is the fear of their clout that holds back PSs from acting until they know who their new bosses will be. A permanent secretary who spoke to us on condition of anonymity, as he too has reapplied for his job, said the absence of cabinet ministers should not slow down the government's functions, since PSs are the ones who do the technical work anyway. Commonwealth practice dictates that when there is no cabinet secretary, the president holds brief for that department. And while in fact this is true, multiple sources have told KTN that the fear of the unknown is holding back sitting government officers from performing any real duties. Yes, they are showing up to work, but they are not willing to append their signatures to any document until they know two things. First, if they will get their jobs back, and second, who their new bosses in the form of cabinet secretaries will be. And the situation could prove disastrous if immediate action isn't taken, as the country is in need of key interventions. The current floods that have spelled havoc across the country lack the daily face of a leader coordinating the efforts. And then there is the budget-making process, which has specific timelines outlined by the Constitution. Yesterday, the president sought to allay fears that all was not well.
The permanent secretary is responsible for various dockets, have been in office. The process of budget making is still on course. And I do believe that as much as the times are really tight, I really do believe that Treasury will submit the required budget policy statement on time and deliver the budget on time.
What may be more puzzling, though, is the fact that the president and his deputy only nominated 4 cabinet secretaries with 14 more positions to be filled.
We wanted to do things differently. We just didn't want to look at CVs and then pick on the basis of CVs. We wanted to meet these individuals and to see how we rhyme together and our ability to work together, and also to get to understand what their own visions for Kenya are.
Despite this explanation by the president, it is not clear why the two, knowing well the challenges in operations, would not present a full list for immediate vetting. Sources within the Committee of Appointments say they are already considering reducing the vetting period for nominees to avert a crisis. While PSs should continue with the technical work, one cloud hangs over them. They do not know where they stand and are unlikely to prejudice their chances of securing a job. Anne Kiguta for KTN.